here's a summary. First, spontaneous. What does that mean? Because we're going to ask you about this stuff. What's spontaneous? That's when delta G, positive or negative? Negative. Okay. E squiggly for the cell is positive or negative? That's positive. And K, I might word this in a different way, but where the products are favored, greater or less than 1. Yeah, if the products are favored, KEQ is greater than 1. We don't really use the word spontaneous with K, but meaning the reaction will go forward, or it favors the products when K is larger than 1. Okay, now let's talk about equilibrium. Okay, for equilibrium, delta G equals 0. E cell equals also 0. And I'm going to kind of word this in a different way for this. For a reaction, when equilibrium lies right in the middle of products and reactants, what's K? No? Yeah, when Q equals K, that's equilibrium. But what is the numerical value of K when we're right between products and reactants? Yeah, 1. So I'll put this a little asterisk by these two. So K is greater than 1, doesn't necessarily mean spontaneous, means the products are favored. And when K equals 1, we're right in between products and reactants. Okay, now let me get some formula summary here. Okay. We've got K here. We've got delta G here, and I'll just use standard values for now, and E cell here. Some of these formulas you haven't seen for a while, so I'm going to kind of rewrite them a little bit. Okay, to go between these two, if you want to convert between K and E cell, as we just learned, it's RT over NF natural log of KQ. And really, you can use any K that we give you. To go between these two at the bottom, we just saw this. Delta G standard is minus NF E standard for the cell. So that calculates between the bottom two. And then on the left-hand side, delta G standard is minus RT ln KEQ. If you want to find this here, knowing nothing else, you can get this from tabulated values and use delta G standard equals delta H standard minus T delta S standard. So that's from before, from Chem2B. You can get this one from tabulated values as well. And here you do a redox reaction and add the two E standards like we've been doing. So you add the E standard for the oxidation and the reduction to get the overall cell E standard. So you can get these from other sources. Then, let me do a little bit more of a summary here. Q, E with no standard, and delta G. So delta G is equal to delta G standard plus RT natural log of Q. So that goes between Q and delta G. This is non-equilibrium right now. But here, this one's simple. This is delta G equals minus NF E. There's no natural log in this one, luckily. And then for the upper right-hand side, this is the Nernst equation. E equals E standard minus, I'll just do it like this, RT over NF. We put in some variables here, times the natural log of Q. So let me zoom out here. These six formulas you need to be really comfortable going between. They're all really plug and chug sort of formulas. They're just scary looking because they have natural logs, but you need to be comfortable going around any of these circles. So let's say you need delta G. You need to get delta G standard. You might need to use a formula up here to get delta G standard. Because say you're given K or you're given E standard. You find this, Q you're given, you'd find from values given in the question, and then you sum this all up to find delta G. So be comfortable wherever you are to go to any other place in this triangle.